It is March 12th, but more importantly, it is the week of WrestleMania 10. Hello, everybody, and welcome into another edition of Superstardom. Your host, as always, EIF owner Carney, and that's right, 6 nights away from the biggest event possibly in the history of this league, Extreme International Fighting, presenting WrestleMania 10, a day we never thought we'd get to, but we will come March 18th. Tonight on the 12th, we have Superstardom, and it's the final stop for Superstardom on that road to WrestleMania. Let's kick things off with two superstars that are looking to be in Money in the Bank, but they'll have to earn their way through it. It's Greedy. It's Midnight. It's somebody random watching who I don't know because they never said, and it's Next. Nexus. Okay, my bad. Speaking of Nexus, he will be in action tonight, along with NBC and Pursuit ASP. Will Ratluck, your guess is as good as mine. Will the baseball slide be legal so certain people can take advantage? Probably so. Sorry. Of course, Midnight will be going one-on-one with Pepsi Killer, while Greedy will challenge E-Bams respectively for two ED Money in the Bank qualifiers. Following that, the winners of that, along with a couple of main event. Hybrid, get Ratluck on. Oh, wait. It's the 12-person auto party load. Shoot. I'm sorry. Hopefully I'm still on because my broadcast just took... Of course. Of course, you can see just Nexus and I taunting in the ring. I'm not in the ring just yet, but. Well, if Ralek's not going to be here, why don't we just do Nexus ASP NBC main event? ASP, I have no idea what you're saying because you talk under your voice and then you do. Yeah, it sounds like that's something you want. We'll go ahead and do that. All right, main event tonight is NBC, Nexus, and Pursuit ASP triple threat main event here on Superstardom. 3/4 of the WrestleMania main event. Eventually, I'll leave. All right, here we go. Ding, ding, ding. And, oh, Midnight Mayfire right out the ring. Midnight, he's going to play the Kevin Owens game from Slow Land. Superstardom will get off to a slow start. Tonight, by the way, is Superstardom episode number 328. Well, Midnight Mayfire, an unorthodox start to this matchup. We'll see what he elects to do. And Greedy will go for the referee. And first strike belongs to Midnight Mayfire. While Midnight is fighting what many would consider an uphill battle, Finn Balor versus The Undertaker, but we've seen underdogs go over The Undertaker, flashback with WrestleMania coming up this week, to a couple of guys that have competed at previous WrestleManias, GTA fan Jinto Superio. Anybody remember that 2011 rivalry with Undertaker and Evan Bourne for the Superstardom and Intercontinental Championship? Very exciting matchups those two had. In fact, that rivalry began on the first ever EIF Tour. Tour program no longer in effect as Greedy gets his head. Looked like it might have bounced on one of those camera monitors. But Greedy was very confident going into this one-on-one. Midnight Mayfire going to be using the speed, and you guys can see that early on in this match as Midnight creating that distance. But Greedy grabbing a steel chair. Greedy has got to be careful about getting disqualified. Dropkick misses, and another sling blade. Second. I was going to say, well, yeah, you do want to be a little cautious, though. It's only been, you've only done five moves, in fairness. True. Really, goals. Greedy going down. I know, you not hitting RT. Dude, calm down, man. I'm not going to call him on everything yet. Jesus. Match just started. Dropkick to Greedy, who is struggling right now. Midnight, you will end up. Yeah, Midnight, you do have to change it up a little bit, though, man. I'm not trying to call stuff on you, but. Obviously, Midnight is having a very good start, though, to this match. Oh, Greedy makes move. So, and sit out, scoop slam connecting. Midnight Mayfire, who has struggled with Finn Balor, hoping to do a lot better. Right back kick on the ropes. Here goes Greedy, and over the top rope, he sends out Midnight Mayfire. Yeah, Greedy has still not actually hit a move of impact. He has hit a reversal. And oh, Greedy looking to dive out. He's not going to get his first move through doing that. At least not just yet. Count of three here. Midnight Mayfire just really using that speed in this. And Greedy once again to the referee, but Midnight this time not able to capitalize, and he gets the referee. Greedy interrupts the move, and he does get a move of impact, ending the no touch. It is a one touch right now. And a single leg lariat connecting. Kick to the chest to Greedy. And another kick. Stomp. And here's that chin lock. And Mayfire obviously only been hit with one move though right now. He is in the driver's seat and by a seismic margin over an entire bar. Still is slightly over half a green bar. Midnight going to back up, going to give Greedy some time. Greedy using a reversal. And Greedy with the clothesline. Well, now Greedy needs to get a comeback going here. Starts stringing together a little bit of offense. Midnight catches him with a dropkick. Greedy running right into that wheelhouse, and then Greedy electing to use another reversal. Clothesline to the back of the head. Well, that damage, and this is going to be the big thing. Greedy does have that powerhouse advantage with Undertaker. Nearly has Midnight out of green off of just a handful of moves, and now Greedy going to return the stomping favor to Midnight Mayfire, but Midnight with the sling blade, first time he did in a while, so. Little break there. Greedy makes movement, so it's all good. Greedy now brought to his feet. And Greedy will be in red now, thanks to Midnight Mayfire. Finisher in hand for the Demon King versus the Dead Man. Oh, one taunt, but had to be careful there. Dropping Greedy down. Midnight Mayfire just trying to keep his momentum. Greedy uses his first ring escape. Greedy trying to shake off what's been a poor start to this match. Well, nearly got the feet of Midnight Mayfire. Midnight keeping Greedy on the outside. Greedy will roll in, and Midnight there to catch him. Greedy with a big right hand. Powerful hit. Midnight Mayfire exchanging. Forearm. And a clothesline from Greedy. Well, Greedy is desperate right now. He does not want to lose this match headed into WrestleMania. This would be an upset victory for Midnight, beating a Hall of Famer and a former champion, a world champion, in fact, on both brands. It's Greedy using that strike force of Undertaker, and there it is, comboing away, teeing off of the head, and he's still not done. Midnight seated to the ground. That health just about even now. Greedy able to come back in that regard. Stamina is still a pretty big difference. And they both exchange reversals, allowing Greedy the upper hand. Elbow to the face, Midnight out of reversals, and out to the ring he goes. or outside the ring. Rudy with a little bit of bravado. Tell you what, Midnight started this match on the outside by just walking right to the outside, but this waiting tactic has worked for him. And that diving move, well, there's the agility, there's the high flying of Finn Balor that you're going to see. And you might see that Finn Balor high flying tactic used in the Money in the Bank ladder match at WrestleMania. So long as Midnight can get past Pepsi Killer. Pepsi very confident, very cocky, actually, going into his qualifying match this Saturday. It actually might be down to 11. I'm sure we'll fare. Greedy almost closing in on his first finisher. And he has it. And oh, wait a minute. Midnight out of reversals. Two finishers. Does he leave the ring? He does not. Midnight is trying to get Greedy to cave on a reversal right now. But Midnight does have the advantage right now, and that's an important note if he gets Greedy to use that reversal. Of course, Midnight's going to be smart and gain one back in his. Midnight not able to strike him. Oh, and Greedy taking the upper hand there. Don't forget, Greedy has that submission. And, oh no, thought he was thinking about it. Remember, Greedy has a chance to win the United States Championship come this Saturday at WrestleMania, as well as Money in the Bank, so he could be leaving with a lot around his waist and possibly in his hand. And Greedy used a reversal. Didn't work out the way Midnight had liked it to. Midnight's going to have to try and rush this right now. He's picking up dead weight on the outside. Greedy thrown into the ring. Midnight going to slide in. Greedy's reversal is closing in. Let's see, is Greedy going to get it back in time? He's not. 1-0 finisher count for Midnight. 19-16 connects. Hooks the leg. 1-2. No, and Greedy kicks out. Midnight trying. Midnight, calm down on the ground stomp. Calm down on the ground stomp. You've done about 45 of them in this match. I'm not joking. So it is a 1-0 finisher count. Oh, Greedy using a reversal right there and a tombstone. Tombstone is going to connect. 1-1 finisher count. Who cares about what you say? Let's see what the ref says. And he's got it. No, both superstars kicking out early. A match that some people were worried about. Now the only person that seems to be worried is Greedy, wondering if he can put Midnight away. Of course, ED coming up later this week as part of our three-day WrestleMania weekend that starts Thursday with ED, then Friday with the Hall of Fame ceremonies, and we'll wrap it up Saturday night. Hey, sneaking. It was Midnight in the ring. He gets clotheslined for his troubles. Midnight. Hit. Midnight backing up and just lets it go. Well, Midnight's played unorthodox in this matchup. At first it was favoring him, now he's on the receiving. He's on the receiving end. And Greedy with a mid move, and that's going to result in basically making this a 2-1 finisher count. Oh no, maybe not yet. Oh, Greedy, he's got some savagery planned. Oh no. What is Greedy doing? Oh no, no. The camera monitors are still on this table, and oh my gosh. Greedy making it a 2-1 finisher count. Referee is still counting. Tombstone through the announce table. Cameras splattering everywhere. Greedy just sent Midnight straight to hell. 6. I believe the count. Wait a minute. Midnight is moving at 7. Referee warning him. Somehow Midnight able to beat the count. Wow. Entertaining matchup, and this is WrestleMania week. We still have WrestleMania to come, folks. It's gonna be an exciting Saturday. Greedy now in the ring. Oh my gosh, Greedy. Yeah, Greedy has got to be careful here. He does not want to get disqualified in a match like this. Should have already, you would argue. And another mid-move opportunity. This time, Greedy not capitalizing. Yeah, but it was a few minutes, in fairness. Oh, well, the referee trying to take the chair out of Midnight Mayfire's hands. Oh, and Midnight drilled by the Big Buddha's first manual ring escape. 1-1 in ring escapes. Greedy distracted by the referee. Midnight has got to take advantage. Here he gets the referee again. Well, Midnight just really starting to, I mean, this is the difference here. You talk about a prolific, wait a minute. Referee is still down. And Greedy isn't going to do anything. Okay. Way to make it hype, Greedy. Oh, wait a minute, what is Greedy thinking? Oh, Greedy looking for the chair guillotine. Greedy's got to be careful. This might result in disqualification. I'm not sure how the refs do this. Oh my gosh, Greedy going up top. Midnight Mayfire has got to get the chair off of his throat, and he does. And he avoided that axe handle just in the nick of time. It was actually kind of cool the way it happened too. And the referee gets taken out once again. Sling Blade. Wait a minute, ref's down. Chair shot to Greedy. Another chair shot. The ref didn't see it, and Greedy somehow still able to take advantage. And Greedy once again, chair around the throat. I don't think he's going to give Midnight time to recuperate this time. Yeah, he is. Never mind. All right, going to the top rope. Midnight Mayfire takes it off. Midnight's got to avoid Greedy for a second here, and he does. Single leg lariat. Well, speed is the big difference in this matchup. Greedy with a reversal. Midnight with a reversal. And a finisher from Midnight. 2-2, 19-16. Would have been on the chair if the ref wouldn't have moved it, that asshole. And let's see if Midnight can get the win. 2. Greedy gets the shoulder up. Midnight, I will let you know, I'm not going to call it right now, but a bad tactic would be every time you get him on the ground, then do 3 stomps. You are definitely going to get called for spamming. You just repeat that same method. Oh, Greedy missing the clothesline. Midnight getting Greedy in the corner. I don't think he knows what to do next, but he did. Greedy with a reversal. Clothesline. Greedy doesn't get anybody. Crucifix. Almost 2 finishers once again in hand for Midnight, and a 2-2 finisher count. I'll tell you what, ED gave us a lot of long matches. But an intense opener here on Superstardom. These guys doing everything they can for momentum. You know, in WrestleMania, I mean, it's a nerve-wracking day, especially for these guys. If you're in the qualifiers, you're going to be some of those opening matchups at the pay-per-view. You want to be feeling good about yourself going into that day. Yes, there is expected to be entrances for them. Yes, that is the plan. No, that's not a plan. I had Ebam's name circled on the whiteboard. All right, and now Greedy finishing Hell's Gate. Well, you know what, Greedy? Maybe this is a sign of desperation for Greedy. Midnight Mayfire gave it a hell of a fight, and I think Greedy started to get a little nervous, and that is why. Oh, well, wait a minute. He got out of it. 3-2 finisher count, but Midnight escapes Hell's Gate. Greedy just clotheslining his way to avoiding it. Wow, Greedy not able to finish his opponent. We talked about him not being able to finish in the past. We're not referring to any bed fiascos, but an enziguri connecting. Greedy now. He gets his opponent up, shoulder press, connecting. The Midnight arm breaker to follow up. And oh, Greedy used his last reversal. He does have the offense though. See what he gets Midnight Mayfire to do. Oh, Midnight used a reversal, and that's not the way he wanted to use one. Missing Greedy entirely there, and Greedy able to keep him on the ground. So Greedy capitalizing despite the fact that he was without a reversal at the time. Now it could be Midnight to be out of reversals. It was, but it was a good time to use one. A very good time for Midnight Mayfire to use one. Midnight, calm down the sling blade. Yeah, dude. We're sitting next time I have to tell you to calm down something, I'm giving him a free move. And now Greedy. Using his comeback. Midnight hung up on that top turnbuckle. Here he goes. Big boot connecting. And Greedy dropping the leg center of the ring, Hulk Hogan style. Greedy with his fourth taunt. And here he goes, teeing off at the body, Rocky Balboa style. And Greedy with the signature. Midnight reverse last time, the Super Wedgie Powerbomb, also known as the Last Ride. He caught the ropes on the way down. Now Greedy has stalled beyond the point now to hit that Hell's Gate, so Greedy has to wait. Oh, and Greedy gonna unravel the turnbuckle. These guys have really been playing loose ruled here. We've seen chairs, announce table. Now the turnbuckle exposed. Will Greedy go back to that at all? Or is it a decoy? Maybe not. Here comes Greedy, putting Midnight in the corner. And Midnight with a boot to the face to reverse. Clothesline to connect. Midnight locked and loaded. Three finishers in his possession. One for Greedy, and he could be looking at one right now. Midnight's got to use that mid-move. He did not do it. It's a 3-1 finisher, or I'm sorry, a 4-2 finisher count for Greedy. Is that the nail in the coffin from the dead man? Not just yet, says Midnight. At the cost of a finisher, I might add. Right hand down. Goes Midnight, and out to follow him is the Greedy one. Yeah. And there was a finisher from Midnight, cutting the lead in half. 4-3 finisher count. Third time the charm for Midnight, almost. Slade Greedy. But people have been joking about it in the party, and we've talked about this as Midnight plays hopscotch, about Greedy being referred to sometimes as bad match. Brandon, wait a minute. What's this? Oh, I thought we almost saw a finisher. Greedy is down, and once again, this is Midnight's problem. He has got to hurry up. And he cannot. He cannot hurry up. And oh, wait a minute, that might have Greedy down for enough. If Midnight can ever figure out the turnbuckles. Well, that's a factor in the match you guys might have to look back on. He lost a lot of stamina and a lot of opportunity there to slay Greedy, and now Greedy with the signature choke slam. And now we have Jolton's friends in the party. Good job, Jolton. Hey, Greedy, timeout. I really can't, right? Never mind. It's hard because I'm on the stream and I can't, like, go into the party without, like, pausing the stream. It just sucks because on the regular shows, there's just no protection in this league. And a tombstone reversal from Midnight. Big reversal there. Two finishers now in hand. Midnight is down by one finisher. And Greedy's gonna back up, and he got the clothesline. Midnight just failing to execute on these pivotal times. Elbow across the face of Midnight. A near half hour classic here. It has been entertaining, that's for sure. And a drop kick. Greedy forced to use his final ring escape. And Greedy now making, I believe that's sexual terms, over to Midnight Mayfire. Sweetie, cutie pie, I don't know. Uh-oh, Midnight out of reversals, and he's gonna hop on out of that ring. Greedy faking his way to the apron. Greedy's been doing a lot of bluffs to try and get Midnight in the ring. There's been a lot of contact with the referee, too, in this match. You have to keep that in mind. I wonder if a DQ would be coming up at any point soon. On either end, I think both guys have taken the ref down at least once. Midnight in the ring. Here comes Greedy charging his way over. And it's a finisher for Midnight Mayfire. 4-4 finisher count. Greedy has already used his ring escapes. Will this be the end of Greedy? Midnight looking for a huge win. He's got the two. He pinned Greedy. Bad match, Brandon. And Midnight Mayfire with a big upset victory. Greedy underestimates his opponent. Midnight Mayfire pays the dividends. An entertaining opener here on Superstardom. I hear you, Redneck. Is it? Oh, okay. Who's the party leader? It's not me. Oh my. All right, anybody want to fight Headshot? James, who are you in Superstardom? All right, well, that means we got to make this a triple threat. Jolton, you love triple threats, right? He's connecting. I know. Jolton, you love triple threats, right? Well, do you or do you not? Okay, thanks for continuing to play the Guess Who game with me, so that way you get pissed when you get one. Doesn't matter. You're getting one now for your insecurities of not speaking up, and it's a triple threat with James R. Coffle and Hedgehogula. It's Randy Orton, Shawn Michaels, and Sting. I didn't know he was here. Oh, my bad. Jumper Shawn Michaels. I'm sorry. Jolton is Dolphy. Dolphy Poo. All right. The match is up. Go ahead and join, please. This works. Yeah, no. I mean, I'm pretty sure, you know, you asked for the next match, and I said this was for you. Yeah. Oh, that would be Delbs. Give him a second. He's wiping back to front. Alright, let me hop out of the ring here for you gents. Ding, ding! Oh, now we got some leg. All right, so anyway, This is a triple threat match. It is Jolton, the United States champion, with Dolph Ziggler, who will defend his title in a triple threat against James R. Koffel and Headshot Killah. Of course, James and Headshot will be involved in Money in the Bank qualifiers. Headshot will also be involved in the Intercontinental title match. Yes, Headshot, I am totally aware of that because I've ran EIF for the last 10 years and almost 1 month. But I do appreciate you trying to give me helpful input. The match card is not in front of me. No, I cannot see it, or can I read English? Thank you very much. Anyway, yeah, that guy wanted me to remind everybody he's competing in a triple threat. And if you didn't fucking know that, well, now you do. Headshot Killah and his Redneck Van Tor guy. He's using the red sting for Redneck. As he goes for a knee, sideswiped by James. Clothesline. The second turnaround, this time Jolton a victim of that. Jumping elbow connects and a little bit of style from Jolton afterward as I nearly knock over a cup of lemonade onto my laptop. Ho ho ho, that would have been exciting. Person that said they wish they would have was Midnight. Headshot, stop. Headshot, stop competing in the match. Go kick Midnight out of the party. And Untamed. Working on them leggies. James loves it. Of course, again, all three of these men looking for momentum headed into WrestleMania. Jolton and Headshot Killah will be competing in their first ever EIF WrestleMania. One of two triple threats, at least, that we will be seeing tonight. As we have the main event, Nexus, ASP, and NBC Master Triple Threat. And now we could be seeing the end of this match. Jolton gets hit with a Scorpion Death Drop, and a quick ending to a triple threat could be in store. One, two. Jolton gets the shoulder up. Aren't you always? Do you have the exact number? Well, as you can hear me talking in the background, DZ competing in his 617th match here tonight. Also, it was announced Tripod will be competing in the main event of WrestleMania. Obviously, a lot of people very excited about that. This will be Tripod's 600th match at WrestleMania. Yep, that's how. You guys, can anybody here, let's play a little bit of EIF trivia with our superstars in the party. Can you guess who texted me complaining about Tripod getting in that match? You are all wrong. Oh, I think I heard, there you go. I heard somebody say it before him. I was gonna say. Yep. He always picks the right times to do it. Like he did it yesterday while I was seeing Kong. He just starts like spamming texts about it. It's not that bad. I mean, I'm not big on it. Yeah, no. I mean, it's pretty decent. Like, it just depends. The thing was, I wanted to take my brother to the theater because this theater is really nice compared to our shitty one at home. Because we were away on the weekend for his hockey tournament, and he only had one game at 1:30 yesterday. Yeah, 3 of 4 games he lost. But they were close games, too. It sucks. They lost 6-4 with an empty net, 5-4 today, and then, well, he's defense, so no. And then they won the one game 4-0. Then they lost one game 9-6. Yeah, he had a couple good hits. But anyway. But yeah, no. So, like, the thing is, I've never been one for everybody that's watching the stream right now. Here's my review on Kong Skull Island. No, I've just never been one for... Headshot, get out of the party. Anyway, I've just never been one for, like, the extremely dumb, unrealistic, you know, movies like that. I mean, obviously, every movie in some ways is kind of unrealistic, but, like, I always prefer comedies. I prefer comedies over everything. And they had nothing good in theaters, like, at all. The only movie they had that I thought, like, I would have remotely been interested in seeing was Get Out. And I saw that 2 days before with the girl I went to theaters with. No, sadly. It was just, that was another movie. That was a movie where I was like, oh, okay, it's a horror movie, I thought. It's not really a horror movie. It's like a thriller, kind of like slight suspense. I mean, or a very different horror. It's not your, I don't know, it was weird. It was okay. I would say pretty good, actually. I would give that like a 6.5 out of 10. Kong, I would have probably given like a 6 out of 10. I'm just not like, I'm not big into those movies. I want to see a movie that makes me laugh. And usually I want to see something that's going to, I don't know. If it's an action movie, I'm usually not going to go unless it's like Dragon Ball Z or like a Batman movie or something, you know. Hey, laugh all you want. DBZ on Rotten Tomatoes got better scores than almost every movie in theaters right now. So, yeah, so do you and your mom. But anyway... Yeah, and I'm not making fun of yours because she's not around anymore. Oh, that's on stream. Oh, actually, I started talking to him again. So, joke's on you. Sweeping off your mom's cemetery stone. Yeah, that's true. I should. I'm sorry. Come on, hey, no. You guys got it, that was pretty decent. RKO out of nowhere! Actually, it was totally predictable. He just picked you up and hit it and used it in reverse. Oh my gosh. I hate you, James. Scorpion Death Drop. Total walk around, but I'm going to give it to him. All right. Hooks the leg. One. Well, he's doing it. Oh, my God. James, come on. I understood why he did it, though. So that's why I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Personally, I think he could have helped it, but whatever. Arguable, but in the case of it not being for a title and in the case of it being a short triple threat on Superstardom, which we will take. Okay. That match was shorter than the one-on-one. It was very good. Yeah, headshot one. James can't kick out of more. Actually, zero. That doesn't count. I hate you. Alright. Neil sent me a message. Flair or whatever. Because I took a picture of my new hockey stick that I got today, and he was like, oh, when are you playing NHL? And I was like, I'd rather play the real thing. Like, the real thing. I'm better at the real thing. Yeah, but I still was better than him. Ask him, I beat him more times than he beat me.
100.
He got like 5 goals. It was quick. Yeah, Brew, typical Brew as goalie, you know?
Fucking hackers.
Oh, what match is next?
Easy gets it on.
Alright, I know what match is next.
Easy versus Bumpkin and Stonefall versus Bumpkin.
Wait, is it a Carnomania?
No.
Okay, well, no, we need to, I was going to do 2 1-on-1s, but who do we have in here? I have Ithic going up against DZ, and then I have Untamed going up. There we go, Untamed. There's your opponent. Yep. All right, hey, Deli. All right, so the first, okay, Deltina, who are you in Superstar Rusev again? Or Carl Anderson now? Carl Anderson, okay, great. So it's good. Who wants to watch Untamed and Deltino? I heard ASP, or I'm going to give it to ASP. I feel like ASP doesn't watch a lot of matches. So, all right, so it's John Cena versus Carl Anderson. This will be different. Oh. All right, the match is up. Please go ahead and join. The match is up. So this is for Deltino, Untamed, and ASP. And laughter, apparently. Wow, you're so evil. Stone Cold and Dean. Been late for Mania? I don't... Yeah, I have. I definitely have done that. It's been a long time since I have, but it did happen a couple of times. Not in Superstardom. Because if Hybrid might not have been able to reverse it at one point. Should, but... Yeah, probably. I would say it's more likely to have that. Where the heck, I swear, I amaze myself sometimes. There it is, okay. At some point I was gonna get counted. Oh wow, I went out on my own. Okay, you guys are excited. All right, ding, ding, ding. And so it is a 1-on-1 Deltino against Untamed Legend. Now, guys, Untamed did lose last week to Rook. A Helocity superstar Deltino has been added to the Helocity roster. And there's a chance that he will end up going 0-2 against Helocity, guys. No, Deltino is. Untamed should be there. But Untamed, of course, in fairness, Untamed is the EIF Intercontinental Champion. Going into a triple threat defense. A lot of multi-mans at WrestleMania. We're going to see what Deltino does now. And the running Luthez connecting for Untamed. Will Jumper be able to get a match? We will have to do, depending on how long this match goes, I might be able to get Jumper a match. Because the only other match I could realistically do is Jumper, DZ, Isaac, and then the triple threat main event. So we'll see, though, because of timing. Electric chair connecting for Deltino. Deltino in need of some big wins. Deltino, have you been showing up to Helocity at all? Oh, well, why don't, here, Deltino, if I were you, I would message Hybrid or Ratluck and let them know that, like, just say Carney told you you were approved for Helocity. But, of course, you can still feel free to show up on the main shows, and we can always use you. Spinebuster connecting there for Tino on Untamed. Of course, this would be a big win for Deltino, considerable looks from the Helocity powers that be if he were to get a non-title victory over the IC champion, which is now an all-ED title effective this Saturday. No longer the co-brand belt. That will be Helocity's championship, which will have its first new champion since Helocity was last crowned in 2011. It's going to be Rook versus Deadly Gamer for the Helocity championship at WrestleMania 10. That makes the Intercontinental Championship an all-ED title and the United States title the all-superstardom title. I've already been told that like 10 times, please. Oh, we're going to have to take him out of the title picture. What? I believe it. I've been warned about that stuff. Untamed teeing off. Oh, you better not ever have that happen again. Close on now, both men out of reversals, but Untamed in the driver's seat, and take a look at the chain gang. You can't see me. Says Untamed Legend. Notice he went to the far side rope, though, so that gives a little bit more time for some reversal to build up, but is it going to be enough time? I don't think it's going to. That reversal's not going to get there, but Untamed doesn't care. He ain't doing the finisher just yet. He said he's more about looking good right now. Of course, Untamed wants to get some points here. Not only is he getting points for days as an IC champ, but he could get points for a win in that BFG standings. Untamed, from what we understand, is towards the bottom of that 16 seeding tournament. Drybug could be way above him with a win this Saturday. If he wins his first, Drybug looking to win his first EIF World Championship on ED in his 600th match. He has never won one in 599 matches. What do you guys think about that? NBC, what's your thoughts on that? What's your thoughts on the fact that Drybug has never been the world champion on ED and this is his 600th EIF match this Saturday? This will be, well, that's very nice of you. And this will be the first time Tripod kind of is in the WrestleMania main event. He was, well, at least it's his third consecutive technically, but last year he kind of sort of was in like a half main event because of Greedy. So anyway, and the attitude has just been adjusted of Deltino. Untamed Legend looking for the yellow bar victory. 2 and not yet. Untamed still very comfortably in the driver's seat. We've seen Deltino show a lot of resiliency in the past. He elected to switch out Rusev for Carl Anderson. We'll see if that helps him out in any case. Untamed with a big right. Untamed just bodying shots. Deltino, forgetting the right trigger is a part of his Xbox One wireless controller. And now Untamed Legend. Lucha DDT could be wired. That's fair. That could be the reason why he's struggling. And Untamed looking for leverage pin for the win. One, two, Untamed can win off of this, but he didn't. Trying to battle back in this match now. You guys can see Deltino might be able to get Untamed in red here. Let's see if he can. Brainbuster. Oh, Untamed just has a little bit left. Tino dropping the weight on him, and now Deltino with an opportunity. What an upset this would be. Imagine Untamed back-to-back weeks losing Deltino. Just be careful in the stall. I'll give you a warning, but back-to-back losing to Helocity people, Untamed, you booty. Untamed with a reversal. Sends Tino to the apron. Hip tossing him right back in. Signature in hand. Don't forget again, our next show later on this week, it's ED coming your way on Thursday. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, wrapping up the week. So we have a few days off after this. And for good reason, it seems like it's going to be a lot of storms in most areas here in the East. Untamed says, you can't see me for the second time. Five knuckle, truffle, shuffle. And here it goes, attitude adjusted. Deltino said, yeah, hit RT. Fuck that, I ain't doing that shit. Two, and because of it, he almost lost, but he did not. Question is, will Untamed need to be good at kicking out? Because if Deltino can hit a finisher, that match can end. Finisher reversed. Oh, that's a big reversal. And now two finishers are in hand for Deltino. A chance to tie the finisher count up. I guarantee I know what's coming. I knew it. You always do that, man. And now I tell you all the time. Oh my God, dude. I've been telling him this since Christmas Blood when he had that one excellent title match. He gets trigger happy. He just ODs on Ritalin. And now salute to the troops. Nexus thinks it's funny because that's what he takes before going to work. Make sure you pay me at 1 o'clock. Hip toss connects. Seriously, I need it, dude. I'm desperate. I'll have to do things I don't want to do for money. Oh my God, that isn't going to be good enough. You're going to have to make an extra 400. And you can make the total 400. I'd be okay with that too. It's going to be like have. See, that's why I don't need a credit card. I have EIF. It works. Oh no, and Deltino cannot do a mid move either. What will they do next? I know, nothing. And now. Oh, okay. And we have passed the midway point of regulation here tonight on Superstardom. Another attitude has been unadjusted. Pursuit ASB having a fun time watching this match. We hope you are too here live on the EIF Network. This is Superstardom episode 328. Now we will wait. Tino in the ring. Luthez connects. Well, Tino's looking good. Attitude adjustment. 3-0. Is it gonna get him 3 on the mat? It does. Untamed Legend with the W. All right, if we hurry, we can pump out 2 triple threats. Let's go, boys. Yeah, I know, but then Jumper joined. So, all right, guys, it's time for Jumper, I Thick, and DV. Jumper, you cool with this? Dean, Sean, and Stone Cold. All right, cool. So we have 2 triple threats to close out the show. Let's do this one first. And hope it's a quick one. Now, I will let everybody know, if this match goes too long, we will not do the following triple threat. That's just how things work in this league. The match is up. We have a goal now. Also, if anybody else is watching the stream and you were hoping to get a match tonight, I apologize, but the cutoff is official. Don't have enough room. He probably made his free account now, thinking he'd get compensated. Tired of people doing that. Aren't they all? All right, ding ding. Ding 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 ding. Hey, stop that. Jumper, we told you about this. It is good, but we can't have you abusing it, all right? But you're starting to get confident, thinking you have friends in this league, and we can't be having that. Oh, hey. Yeah, Untamed. Dude, we hear you, man. We don't want you here.
Thank you.
Yep. I stopped when you joined. I think he kicked out. DZ with the win! Good job, DZ. You ended in reasonable time, too. All right, it's time for our main event, which I will commentate. Good match, though, guys. No, I told everybody the cutoff. If you'd watch the stream and support our league, you would know. All right. Bragging rights. Okay. All right, it is time for our main event, and in 6 nights from now, these three men will be accompanied by Ratluck. He thinks he's too important for Superstardom, so we're going to do these three in a triple threat main event. ASP, Nexus Genesis, and the defending Superstardom champion for this Saturday's WrestleMania 10 main event, NBC Master. The match is up. Please go ahead and join. Again, this is the final Superstardom match for EIF before this Saturday's WrestleMania, and we have such a jam-packed week for you guys. Remember, this Thursday, we, I believe, have more of a matinee-friendly time. It looks like did I even write the show schedule down? Or did I write it down? Is there? No, I didn't. I'm pretty sure it's 5 to 7. Somebody, DZ, did I tell you 5 to 7 Thursday? Okay. Well, if you check the Twitter account, EIF Network, we should have that information for you there, though I'm almost 100%. It's either Thursday 5 to... Nah, it's Thursday 5 to 7. Right? Yes, Nexus? Day, evening, night. That's what it is. Yep, we're using... No, what do you mean, except for the main event? Oh, well, yeah, that would technically be the... Yeah, but we'll do the entrances, yeah. We might just do it. I don't know. Probably in the order of which people were eliminated in the Turnbuckle Turmoil. So, like, NBC will come out last, followed by AS or ASP before him, and then you and Ratluck will start. It really doesn't matter, though, when you factor it in, because realistically it's like a minute to 2 minutes. It'd be different if it was a five, man. But all right, here we go, guys. Ding, ding, ding. Of course, NBC Master chose a no-submission elimination chamber for this Saturday's pay-per-view main event. Again, guys, you can check out our EIF Network on Twitter using at EIF Network. You can get the show schedule. Though I do believe, I want to say it's safe to say that we do have that ceremony, the show at 5. Then on Friday, we have the Hall of Fame ceremonies. Yes, only two people getting inducted, but two very important people, especially to the last few years here in EIF. Two guys that everybody knows, a lot of people have had the privilege of being in the ring with. Those are Deathlock and Aaron Phantom, our two 2017 Hall of Fame inductees. Will be honored Friday evening. I believe the scheduled start time is 11 p.m. Eastern for that. And then WrestleMania, this is big news. Obviously, WrestleMania is usually held from a 12 to 12 special. There is a chance it will be a 1 to 12 special this year. We'll get more details on that throughout the week. I'm hoping by Wednesday I can get it confirmed. All right, we are back. I apologize about that. I had to take care of something. Anyway, back to the match, because that is what's important. Sling Blade connecting for Nexus Genesis. Again, this is a momentum win for these guys as ASP rolling to the outside. Next is Genesis, possibly in the driver's seat. Who would have thought your most damaged person would be the Superstorm champion, NBC? He could be a target this coming Saturday as Nexus flies to the outside and attacks ASP. Everybody with finishers but the Superstardom champion. He will get a signature, though, after that German suplex. NBC, Nexus, and ASP all in their first WrestleMania main events. Nexus and ASP, their first overall WrestleMania appearance. NBC won the opening match at WrestleMania 9. Who would thought he would go from opening the show 1 year to closing it the next on his fourth reign as Superstardom champion? Pursued ASP looking for his first, Nexus his second, after he played tag with NBC for that championship. And a back suplex to connect. Running knee connecting. ASP has done the best momentum-wise in this match. Here comes the champion, though, trying to climb his way back. Snapping suplex. And ASP, keep rolling. And here's NBC. Well, I'll tell you what, NBC was not doing the best to start this match, but it takes one Kimura to end it, or in this case, Nexus, to run to the outside. Don't forget to stay tuned after the show for our signature outro to find out our multi forms of social media that you can check EIF out once the show is over, as well as what's the look ahead this week. We already talked a little bit about it. WrestleMania week here in EIF. Everybody with finishers and Nexus on the outside, if NBC can target correctly, could be the same ending we saw at Turnbuckle Turmoil 2 weeks ago. ASP with a forearm to the back of NBC. DDT to follow up. Two finishers in hand for Pursuit ASP. NBC with one, an important one though. NBC to the apron. ASP to the apron, the turnbuckle. Who's gonna hit who? ASP goes sit it down. He's thrown off the turnbuckle from NBC Master. That leaves the challengers in the ring. Of course, this match not for the title. The one Saturday is. All five championships in EIF defended this Saturday. WrestleMania not known for good success rates with championships. In fact, the Superstardom Championship, which had its first title defense in EIF at a WrestleMania, WrestleMania 3. That was the first time that the Superstardom Championship was defended. It has been defended at every WrestleMania since, and it has been successfully defended just one time. Deathlock did that at WrestleMania 8, so NBC not stepping into fair territory. And in fairness, Deathlock was also in a one-on-one with Tripod. NBC will not be so lucky. He'll have three challengers to deal with as he runs out to the ring, or the outside of the ring, rather. ASP with a crotch chop. Thank you. Three men, all three in the ring right now. First to leave is Nexus. NBC will follow. ASP will stand ground, maybe. Good. All men on the outside now. Oh. NBC with a takedown to Nexus on the outside, and now NBC stalking his prey in the ring. But then he forgot he had to step a little forward. And oh, ASP had the motion of the finisher. For whatever reason, it did not go. ASP getting momentum off momentum off momentum. One, two, and three finishers respectively. ASP, whoa! Awkward animation. What's ASP thinking? ASP with two finishers now. Whoa, German suplex from the middle rope. NBC Master, welcome to Suplex City, and welcome to the clutches of the Kimura. Nexus trying to reach for the rope. Official looking to see if he can get there. He cannot get to the rope, but he can get out of the submission. This is not the first time Nexus Genesis has gotten out of the Kimura. He will not have to worry about getting out of it Saturday for the fact of no submission. Kick untamed out of the party. MVC looking for the stomp, didn't get it. Oh, MVC. Making million-dollar moves. ASP staying in, not rolling anywhere. MVC keeping a heavy eye on him, but one in the back of his head as well. We see Nexus peeking. This, again, is our main event here tonight. Three triple threats. Superstardom full of multi-mans this evening. No, I just said this is our main event. Oh, yeah, sarcasm. Okay, I got it. Champion to the outside. Have a dark match after. Here comes MVC. What's ASP going to do? And MVC's going to flex his muscles. MVC will not get any forward in the offense there. Oh, maybe he does not. Good clothesline to the back. Kick to the back. Nexus reversing. Nexus with three finishers. And MVC. ASP trying to regain some consciousness on the outside. Oh, Nexus was almost helping him. MVC with some arrogance for his fourth taunt. Oh! Down goes ASP. MVC found ASP, and ASP mid-move the F5. And ASP does not know how to target. Big, big factors that WrestleMania is going to be hinging on. Fifth taunt. So if you taunt, it erases that like mid-move thing. RKO reversal, and boy is Triple Randall feeling good. I am, as we have some outside action going around the All-American. MVC looking to grab, but the only thing he's grabbing is his own ass in real life. Nothing happening here. Alexa's throwing ASP. And this is one of the factors that you battle with a triple threat, but you have to remember, folks, if you're watching this now, this Elimination Chamber match is going to change the dynamic that you're seeing right now. This runaway game is not going to be able to be as popular as it is here when it comes to the Chamber Saturday night. Of course, these guys hopefully wanted to put a show on at WrestleMania. There's that striking game. NBC is going to be able to. And the F5, but it was reversed. ASP making movement. Forearm to the face, right back kick stop. No finishers in hand for NBC Master. Two apiece for the others. And there's a finisher for ASP, and there's a ring escape. And now looking for the finisher, here's Nexus. Curb stomp. Nexus taking too much time. One, two, NBC's gonna have to use it. Oh man. Oh yeah. ASP trying to keep Nexus in the ring, but this runaway game, this is something that these three guys all implementing. Six taunts, NBC down to one more taunt. Jeez. When does anybody max out taunt rules anymore? Oh! NBC almost kept the offense, but he's just going to go to the outside. Something you'll see every 11 seconds, and you wonder why I don't commentate triple threats. Hopefully not the case at WrestleMania, because we do have like three of them, I think. NBC, well, we already have this announce table prepared once. And F5 connects. Water bottle, JBL hat, cameras everywhere. Little lag now because of that. This is awesome chance. And now NBC looking to call it a game or not. He has got to hit this finisher. He has got to hit this finisher to win his match Saturday, and he is not having luck with it tonight. A Nexus from the brink of extinction. Curb stomp. And now the pedigree. Mid move. Mid move, and NBC can still get pinned. NBC is still eligible to get pinned. He did not make movement. 2-9 MEC. Wow. Okay, where's your knowledge? He's got 21% momentum. Yeah, he also has red health. MBC rolling to the outside. Yo, you guys are seeing. Oh my god, Nexus! We got a flying redneck. Come on, Nexus. What do you like about Jack? What's there not to like about Jack? It's reversed. Good way to do it. I like it, Nexus. Show me that format again. There's a little base form you got going. Oh, Nexi with Levy. And I meant to say Levi. Levi jeans. The preferred jeans of your Panera Bread baristas. German suplex from MVC to ASP. Roly, poly, oly. At 7 taunts, MVC is now out of taunts. So when you do a taunt there, just to clarify, when you do a taunt there, and you don't have, like, the debuff from the mid-move, what does it do? Is, like, your move, is it more impactful? Do you... Okay. So how do you know what you have right now? Well. We're all learning today. And a finisher! Will NBC mid-movie? Of course not. He hits that shit like a minute and a half early. NBC hit RT spamming as soon as his first arm was hooked. Seth Walker. Main event stretching the distance here of our show. Dropkick misses. She's still here, or is it just him? She might have left for the night. NBC with a reversal. There we go. MSP looking for a big win here in the main event. No. Oh my goodness. Oh no, well we're about to hit OT here. So much for talking to my mom tonight. She didn't want to see me anyway, right boys? Let's just keep wrestling. Well, I mean, I'm home for the week. Yeah, it's spring break. Yeah, sure. Is it the Velcro one with the Rugrats strap? Kimura is locked. End the show. Oh my goodness. And you have to think, based on how this match is going, NBC is going to be struggling to find answers. Come this Saturday at WrestleMania.
it's me watching. Sorry, dude. I was sending a tweet. Holy hell. Oh, here comes the pedigree.
Or not.
Wow. Is that it? Oh.
Going into overtime officially here.
Guy. Oh my gosh.
You guys are choosing terrible times, you're just not ending it.
My goodness, guys. Hey, we might make it so that you guys have to stay in the ring. We might have to, because this is like 40 minutes now. Yeah, well, realistically, man, I got home for the first time in a while, so, you know, it'd be nice. I know you guys, you know, ZIF, so. Texas with the win, and the crowd goes home happy.
Well, Nexus Genesis, the winner in this triple threat. Will he be the winner in this Saturday's Fatal 4-Way Elimination Chamber match when the title is on the line? It will be his first WrestleMania, and it will be the main event. We look forward to that this Saturday, but before that, we have our show Thursday for ED, as well as the Hall of Fame induction ceremony Friday evening. For the information and times of those shows, please check out our Twitter page using @EIF Network. You can follow us here on Twitch in the meantime, as well as subscribe to our YouTube channel, EIF Archive. That's EIF Archive. And for any other inquiries you may have, please head over to our main website. It's leaguelineup.com/EIFLives. Another show in the books. We apologize this show went a couple minutes over, but we thank you for waiting with us to the end, those who saw it through. Thank you. We'll see you guys once again this Thursday for the final regular show before WrestleMania 10. For everyone here at EIF, I'm Carney. Have a good night, and we will see you then.